Philip, Democrats say that this is nothing short of an abuse of power by Donald Trump.
Well, I think it shows two things, Laura. First of all, that Donald Trump is absolutely sure that he won the election. And whatever happens, he is not going to change his mind. He's going to carry on crusading to the end of his life to say that he won this election and it was a fraud and that Joe Biden lost and that he should have had a second term in office. This is showing also, second point, Donald Trump's modus operandi and the way he talks to people and the way he handles things. And it sort of starts off being complimentary, then it goes on to be asking questions, then he goes on to be rather threatening, and then he becomes critical. And we'll see that criticism. We saw it afterwards on the tweet that was posted by Donald Trump, where he said that Brad Raffensperger, the Georgia Secretary of State, had no clue. So there is this psychological pressure which has been put on many people during Donald Trump's time in office. And that is why you have, I think, within the Republican Party itself, this split between those who will go with the president for peace of mind and those who are now going to feel liberated of by the president that he is going to be out of office very shortly and probably would have gone along with it because they don't want to be assassinated by Donald Trump via Twitter if they go against what he's saying. And this is just another example with what he has been talking about with Brad Raffensperger. But once again, OK, wanting 11,780 votes, where is the proof? Where is the proof there was electoral fraud? There is none. He's not offering anything. He's just saying, I need those votes because that will give me the win that I want.
Now, whether he likes it or not, Donald Trump's spell in power is inevitably coming to an end in less than 3 weeks. However, his party, the Republican Party, does still control the balance of power in Washington. That could change tomorrow. Also in the state of Georgia, we've got two crucial Senate runoff races. Might that phone call have an impact on that?
Well, the big question now is, will those Republicans who say they will not vote to accept the election result in the November election result, will those 11 Republicans led by Ted Cruz, who say they want a 10-day commission to look into electoral fraud, will this telephone conversation push them to change their minds? I don't think it's going to push them to change their minds, but I don't think it's going to have any effect on the overall outcome of this election. What may happen is in this runoff that those who may have been tempted to vote for one of the two Republican candidates in Georgia in these elections taking place this week, remember that Donald Trump is there today, as is Joe Biden. They will not be meeting. There'll be no handshaking ceremony or anything like that, but they're both there to support their own candidates. Those who were thinking about voting for the Republicans may change their mind and vote for the Democrats. And if the Democrats put it off and their two candidates do, and then there will be a 50-50 tiebreak in the Senate, and that will mean that it will be Kamala Harris, the incoming vice president, who will have the deciding vote, and that will mean that the Senate will be under the control of the Democrats, like the House of Representatives, and that will make it much easier for Joe Biden to pass any laws and legislation once he takes office on the 20th of January. If the Republicans keep hold of the Senate, then obviously it will be much more difficult for Joe Biden after that date. Let's say this conversation by President Trump may have helped a little bit in pushing people to vote maybe Democrat rather than Republican in that runoff.
Philip, thanks very much. Philip Turle there.